9,999. 10,000. No, I haven't just flipped that coin 10,000 times, but if I wanted some statistical significance, then that's the amount of times you would need to flip a coin to see how many times it would land heads and tails. Why are we talking about statistical significance in this video? Well, I wanted to discuss with you here on the Rebel Betting channel if your betting strategy is profitable or you're just being lucky. Now, with a perfectly balanced coin, you would expect 5,000 heads and 5,000 tails when flipping it 10,000 times. But if you were to get 6,000 heads and 4,000 tails, you would know for a fact that there is something wrong with that coin. Maybe it's heavier on one side or something like that. Now, if I were to flip that coin just 10 times and had heads 10 times in a row, that would not prove anything because there just is not that statistical significance there in numbers to prove anything at all. The exact same thing applies when we're talking about sports betting strategies. If you were to place 100 bets with an average odds of 2.0 and get a 5% yield, which is profit per dollar invested, of course, there's still a 1 in 3 chance that you got that result just out of pure luck. In that example, the p-value is below 0.3. The number of bets that you need to place, just like with the coin flip, is much higher than most people intuitively think. For example, if after 1,100 bets you still have that 5% yield, you're most likely onto something. The risk of these results being pure chance is now just 5%, meaning a p-value of less than 0.05. So there is a 95% chance that there is something else going on, like either skill or a profitable value betting strategy. A p-value below that 0.05 is generally accepted as statistically significant, but that is a highly arbitrary limit. There is nothing stopping you from requiring stricter proof, like a p-value below 0.01. If you'd like to learn more about the maths behind this, I'd recommend reading further into statistical significance, the t-test, and p-value. There'll be a few links down in the description for helpful articles to help you learn more. But that is going to do it for this video. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in a future video here on the Rebel Betting channel.